Good day everyone, my name is Sauro Paperini and I am the project leader at Giron. I've been working for Giron for about 5 years and I handle the design, the development and the installation of all our shielding systems.
Hello, I'm Eleonora Fazzi and I've been on Giron team for about 8 months. I work for both the technical and the sales department of the company.
Giron's shielding systems are custom made according to the customer's specific needs. Because of the product's combining and shaping capabilities, you can create whatever structure you want, as it adapts very easily to any building or architectural context.
We can see now what a typical project is like, from the customer's first request to the final control checks after installation. To best demonstrate our work, we will show you a few pictures of a site we worked on about 3 years ago, in a power cabinet in Florence. Our customer was Enel, the first Italian electricity company, and second in Europe. First phase, the customer's request. Enel contacted us directly after they measured the magnetic fields on one of their own power cabinets, located near a few apartments. The measurements showed induction levels higher than the legal limit, which is 3 microtesla for population.
Phase 2. Giron site inspection and setting a plan of action with the customer. Giron and Enel staff conducted an inspection of the site in order to acquire as much information as possible and to know the architectural concept of the site. So we took other measurements with our own equipment to understand the orientation of the electromagnetic field and its real intensity in different points on site. We took some measurements inside the power cabinet and in the adjacent rooms that needed to be protected. Phase 3. Drawing the shielding project. Giron drew a project according to the measurements taken and the goals to reach. Once on paper, the project was then submitted to Enel for acceptance.
Phase 4. Installation of the shielding system. We then proceeded to installing our product using expert staff trained by our technicians. The shielding system was installed according to the plan. On the pictures, you can see that our product was installed on an additional galvanized steel structure, which can be avoided by sticking it directly to the ceiling and walls, thus saving on the final product's thickness. Phase 5. Covering with plasterboards, if requested. Covering our shielding system with plasterboards. If the customers request it, we can cover our shielding system with standard water repellent plasterboards. We can also install fire resistant plasterboards of any ratings. The plasterboards can also be painted with a tempera paint or a water-based paint. If the plasterboards installation is not requested, we recommend the customer grounds the installation.
Phase 6. Measurements and final technical report. Once the installation is completed, we take new measurements with the power on, and then we issue a final technical report that includes the induction levels we measured.
Besides the standard application we have just seen, we can also provide, upon the customer's request, shielded conduits for busways, power cable and underground power lines.
When facing unusual architectural needs, we can adapt our product to other applications, such as this self-supporting structure ordered by Prada, which we installed in Ca Corna della Regina in Venice.